Studio, please. Studio, please. Thank you. The representative of the rector. Directors here present, heads of departments, staff of the academy here present, our most esteemed resource persons, cadets, members of the press, good morning. We are about to commence proceedings for today's program. And I'd like us to be aware that it is a culture here that when we all gather together for an event like this, we commit such events to the hands of the Almighty God. We shall do so by reciting the second stanza of the national anthem for our opening prayer. and we are expected to please be uprising. Please, may we rise. Thank you very much. We shall be reciting the second stanza of the national anthem for the opening prayer for today's event at the count of two. One, two. O God of creation, direct our noble course, guide our leaders right, help our youth the truth to know, in love and honesty to grow, and living just truth, great lofty height attain, to build a nation where peace and justice shall reign. You may now please be respectfully seated. Thank you very much. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, please permit me as I hand over this section to my co-MC to bring us up to speed with the security brief.
Thank you very much. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. As we are all aware, apart from those who might be stepping into this auditorium for the very first time, this is the Right Honorable Chibike Rotimi Amechi Auditorium of the Maritime Academy of Nigeria. And in this auditorium, we have three exit doors to your left, to your right, and just right behind you where you are on your seated position. In case of any emergency or any outbreak of fire or any other emergency, you are advised to walk briskly to the exit doors for further instructions. And also, we have our fire extinguishers very, very ready. We have the automated and the manual, whichever it is, they are working. There's no cause for alarm. This is also very, very important for us to know. The muster point of this auditorium is just over the fence, just after the car park, in case of any emergency. Also, we have our conveners at the door behind you, the exit door behind you, and on your seated position to your right is for the ladies, and on your seated position to your left, which is my right, is for the gents. And in case you finish using any of those conveniences, you are advised to make it clean and neat for the next person coming to make proper use of them. Thank you very much. In case you need anything and you do not know your way around, please, we are here to answer your questions, or you can ask any of our security personnel and they will properly guide you. Thank you very much. You're welcome once again to the Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Right Honorable Chibike Rotimi Amechi Auditorium. Good morning. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Samuel. At this juncture, very distinguished and esteemed guests, it is our intention to identify each and every one of you seated here by name to acknowledge and recognize you. But due to time constraints, we would want to run through the list of introduction we have here within the time available at our disposal. Please, as we identify our esteemed, very important personalities in our midst, we're expected to please appreciate them with a resounding applause. First, very distinguished guest, join me as I acknowledge and welcome to you the presence of the registrar of this academy, Mr. P. Netsin, with a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, sir. Thank you for coming. Ladies and gentlemen, we also have with us this morning the director of the School of Engineering, Engineer Williams Ekwere. A round of applause for
very distinguished guest, ladies and gentlemen. We are very honored this morning to have in our presence the Director, School of Maritime Transport Studies. He is Mr. Gabriel Eto. With a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, please, let's appreciate him.
All right, we also have with us this morning the presence of the Regimental Unit Commander, the REC of the Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Lieutenant Commander D.N. Danabaju.
Make that resounding applause for him, ladies and gentlemen. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. We have in our midst the head of quality control, Mr. Dr. Akeem Lawal. Please, a round of applause for Dr. Akeem Lawal. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. We also have with us the head of public affairs unit, department, I beg your pardon, Ms. Domo Okon-Omo-Ekbe. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to draw your attention to this very important personality in our midst, the head of ICT department, Mr. Dele Onarinde. A round of applause for him, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to, at this point, invite to the podium the chairman's speech for today's event. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mr. P. Netsin, the registrar of the academy. Please mix that with a sounding applause one more time. Thank you.
Now I'm very tall, and I want to be seen. The management staff, the guest speaker, friend, personally and friend of the academy, you are most welcome, sir. Our dear loving cadets, the rapporteurs, I acknowledge all of you, including a humble RUC. This is the continuation of our series of lectures. Yesterday we had two presentations, and this morning we'll continue and conclude this afternoon. I'm very sure that the cadets, you were able to capture the presentations of yesterday, and we are set for this morning paper. The paper said was set for a successful career after graduation. After graduation. I want you to know that it's a competitive world. So for you to be successful, you need to be well equipped. And that is the essence of this series of lectures. And our academy had deemed it fit to invite expertise in their own fields. When it comes to citation of Captain Morin, you know more about him. But I can assure you, he will give you nothing but the best. And for your own future, he will certainly do that. He can do anything. He can sacrifice anything for the sake of the academy. And on behalf of the director, I want to welcome you, sir, and welcome everyone. Rector personally wanted to be here, just like I mentioned yesterday, but he has to attend national assignment. He's likely to join us. Hopefully, should he return early, but he wish you well. And I personally, on behalf of the organizing committee, the management, and all the staff, we wish you well. Please have a listening attention to our dear friend, Captain Omoren. Once again, you are welcome.
Thank you very much. Please make that a resounding applause. That is the registrar of the academy, Mr. P. M. Netsin. Please make that a resounding applause again. That's the registrar. Thank you very much, sir. very distinguished guest, ladies and gentlemen. Yesterday we had a robust time here, and today we are going to be moving in same speed and light. And before we do that, I'd like to request my colleague to make introduction.
Thank you very much, Mr. Destiny. Before we go over to introduction and the citation of our guest lecturer for this morning, I'd like to recognize the presence of the members of the fourth estate of the Rev, the press. Please can we give them a round of applause for a round of press that I hear. We appreciate your coming. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this morning we have a resource person carefully selected for today's paper presentation. I'd like you to please join me as I will, at this juncture, make welcome to the podium, Captain Sunday Michael Omoren. With a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Make that a resounding applause. Thank you, thank you. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to run through the profile of Captain Sunday Omoren, the Secretary General of the Memorandum of Understanding on Port State Control for West and Central Africa Region, Abuja Memorandum of Understanding. Captain Sunday Michael Omoren is a master mariner with deep knowledge and experience in many facets of shipping, from shipboard experience to marine operation, owners and charterers perspectives, quality assurance, shipboard, internal and external audits and terminal due diligence, fleet renewal and vessel acquisition exercises, and currently plays an active role in the regulatory and enforcement aspects of shipping. Distinguished guests, during his sea-going career, he sailed through many seas and oceans and has expanded experience with multinational crewing, with a typical experience of being the master of a vessel with crew from 11 nationalities. I think you should be putting your hands together for him. As with any seasoned seafarer, Captain Sunday Omoren has encountered many rough seas, storms, and typhoons during his career at sea. Captain Sunday Omoren is a natural relationship builder owing to his strong communication abilities, exceptional understanding, and application of emotional intelligence. He leads and inspires large teams while developing beneficial relationships with colleagues and stakeholders, with a balanced focus on the company's bottom line ROI and top line growth. His watchword and advice to managers are, you don't have to be bossy to be a boss. Distinguished guests, on his seagoing career, Captain Sunday started his career as a private cadet in the then Nautical College of Nigeria, now Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron, and was later employed in the cadetship program of the defunct Nigerian National Shipping Line, NNSL. Upon his graduation from the Arab Maritime and Transport Academy in Egypt, he was promoted to the rank of fourth officer and later served as a third officer before the company was liquidated. During the period with NNSL, he gained practical experience by working with seasoned merchant navy officers who made great marks on his attitude, demeanor, and career. Very distinguished guest, ladies and gentlemen, with the liquidation of the NNSL, he moved to the Far East, Singapore, where he progressed through the ranks from third officer to the rank of master on foreign-going vessels. His shipboard experience covers services on board general cargo ships, container and tankers, product and chemical vessels. Very distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on his shore career, after a successful career at sea, he joined the Nigerian Liquefied Natural Gas Limited, NLNG, in 2001 as deputy head shipping operations, and thereafter served in several positions including head, shipping operations, fleet superintendent in Europe, America, and the Far East, project coordinator of the ship management, knowledge transfer project, and BGT charterer administrator before voluntarily resigning from the company in 2014. Captain Sunday, as a fleet superintendent of NLNG, managed the operations and delivery of LNG cargoes to Europe, America, and the Far East. Hence, his undisputed familiarity with different cultures and work ethics. Gentlemen and ladies, he joined the Nigerian Maritime Administration and Safety Agency, NIMASA, in 2014, where he served as the Deputy Director of Seafarers Training and Certification, Head of Cabotage Services Department, Head of the Maritime Safety and Seafarer Standard and Certification Department, and rose to the position of a Director. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Sunday Umoren is the current Secretary General of Abuja. He was appointed as the Acting Secretary General of the MOU in January 2021 and was confirmed as the Substantive Secretary General at the committee meeting before that year. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Sunday Umoren is also a part-time lecturer at the PGD Institute of Maritime Studies and MSc Hydrographic Department, University of Lagos, Lagos State, Nigeria, and was one of the Nigerian delegates to Maritime Safety Committee meeting in the International Maritime Organization, IMO, serving in many subcommittees. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, on his qualification, Captain Sunday Umoren has obtained a Master of Business Administration, MBA, in the University of Hull, United Kingdom. I thought you'd be putting your hands together for him. He also has a Class 1 Certificate of Competency in Maritime Navigation, Master Mariner Foreign Going. He has also obtained a certificate in Advanced Diploma in Maritime Transportation in Singapore. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Umoren has obtained the best graduating cadets in Nautical Studies Department in 1987, Maritime Academy of Nigeria, Oron, and has also obtained an award from the MDCO Special Recognition Award, Nigeria LNG Limited, for business achievements. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, please join me as I introduce to you a man of much less modesty. He is no other person other than Captain Sunday Michael Umoren, our guest lecturer for today's first paper presentation. Please make that a resounding applause for him. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, the MC. You know, it's a common practice that we stand on existing protocol. But being who we are, being the sons and daughters of who our parents are, there are personalities that you just have to acknowledge and not just stand on existing protocol. State your own protocol. So first, I'd like to thank the rector for yet another opportunity to speak to you guys. I don't take this opportunity for granted. You know, it's a privilege that can be withdrawn, you know. And for us, every opportunity to impact knowledge into the next generation, like the registrar mentioned this morning, succession planning, it's important. We take it very seriously. I also acknowledge the registrar, Mr. Tu, and Dr. Lawa, the RUC commandant. Oh, he's gone, so I can say it. You know, in our own time, we never really liked them, the RUC guys. But you know, looking back today, we always are grateful to them, because that discipline is what you need on board the vessel. Okay? And so, yes, so okay. All the directors here present, And all the stakeholders, never make light of your stakeholders. All the stakeholders, covering everybody. And of course, the graduates, it's your day. So please clap for yourselves. So thank you for this opportunity. And yes, we have the business of the day. But I won't start the business of the day without highlighting two things. One on the sad side and the second one on the positive side. I'll start with the positive one that occurred. I came in on Monday. An incident that occurred at the airport that Monday. I sat down waiting for our flight. And there was this nice man, well-dressed. I mean, you won't pass without turning to look at him. All of a sudden, one young man came to him. And the man was just opposite me. And the young man, he introduced himself to the man. So-and-so, I work at the restaurant here. I'm a graduate, and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, started selling himself. And so the man said, so what are you selling? He said, I just want to tell you that, yes, I have a job today, but I'm not very satisfied with this job, sir. I approach you to ask if you have any opportunity to offer to me, and I promise I will never let you down. I was just watching them. And the man, too, very responsive man, looked at him and said, okay, take my number. He gave the young man his number. And this is the bit I like about the young man. Some have just taken the number and walked away. But the guy decided to dial him to be sure that the number was correct. So he dialed, and the phone rang. So the man picked it up. So when the young man left, I asked the man, excuse me, sir, have you met him before? He said, no. But he's just taken aback at the level of confidence the guy has. You know, so I look back and say, okay, I'm coming to you guys to talk to the graduates that, look, every opportunity, avail yourself of every opportunity. And I'm very sure if that man had turned down the young guy, he wouldn't have been moved. At least he had taken a step. So sometimes in taking your step, you could be rebuffed. Don't let it weigh you down. When one door is closed, many doors are open. And I just like one quote from one man of God that said, even closed doors are answered prayers. I don't know whether you guys get that. For those that don't get it, probably by next week you will understand it. Even closed doors are answered prayers. If you go to a place looking for a job, knock on their doors, go in, and then you are rebuffed, they kick you out. Look back at it and say, probably God didn't want me to be here. Because sometimes a particular job can actually wear you down. It's not the best job. It's out of you. It's out of sync with your destiny. But that job keeps you from your destiny. And so for such doors, you want God to shut them. Let God just lead you to the right doors that are meant for you, aligned with your destiny. And everything will go well. So we'll start off with... I tried to make this as practical as possible. I interviewed one of our ex-cadets who I had mentored over the period. And so I told him, I said, can you just have a page or a pager on your story so that I can share with the cadets today? So he was kind enough to write this down, which we're going to present to you guys. The MC has a better voice, so I want him to just read it to us.
All right. Thank you very much, sir.
No.
While we wait for the slide to come up.
Yes, sir.
Oh, God, this guy is always confused.
All right. Thank you. It says here, life most often is not a bed of roses, and only those determined and focused can make life worthwhile and memorable. My name is Engineer Okon Ears, currently working as a second engineer on a search and rescue ship in the Central Mediterranean. Climbing through the career ladder had not been easy and was filled with hurdles, which made me discover more opportunities while pursuing my dream. After my academics in 2015, I was mandated to go for sea phases, also known